Celebration Exchange for Media is back again with another episode of E4M Next Gen series, where we are celebrating the win of all the winners of the second list of E4M PR and COPCOM 40 Under 40. Today we have with us Ms. Pooja Trehan, who is the founder of Prestorens and co-founder of PRPOI. So welcome, Pooja. It is a pleasure to have you with us.
Thank you so much, Nafisa. It's a privilege for me to be here.
Okay, so starting the interaction, my first question will be, what do you feel about being in the second list of E4M PR and COPCOM 40 Under 40?
I'm sure I can resonate, what each and every winner must be feeling right now. It's actually a privilege to be part of this list where every communicator aspires to be present in. I also feel it's inspiring when you become part of a handpicked list across the country. So there's no other better way to say that thanks to the esteemed jury members and Team Exchange for Media, that thank you again for acknowledging the contribution that we as communicators have made to the industry.
Awesome. And I think the celebration should, continue with this year being not so good in terms of good news. So this has come as a celebration time for all of us. So Pooja, my next question has to be around, like, there are so many changes that we have seen the PR and the communications industry going through. So, and the market has changed drastically if we see in from the past 10 months. So what, according to you, are the key skills that are required in the prevailing market?
Honestly, it just takes us back to basics. And the first thing, content is king, that everyone would, loves to say that again and again. So curating content, the art of controlling your storytelling and your narrative, and the practice to adapt to this ever-evolving environment. The kind of changes that we've gone through this year is probably the biggest crisis chapter for any communicator. So what we also need throughout all of this is immense focus and the right message to audiences. This is all integral to us. But today, more than ever, what we need is to inculcate humility and empathy in all our messaging and personalize it as much as possible for our consumers. I think these are our key skills, rather something that we need to keep upskilling to at every time.
Okay, adapting and personalization are the new key skills required. Sure. Awesome. And, you have been a leader and you are now an entrepreneur running your own firm. So what are the challenges that you have faced as an entrepreneur in this industry? And what are the changes that you've come across being on the other side of the table?
See, when you're part of an organization or a brand or a PR agency or a company, it's far more easier because you have very, very well-designed roles. But when you're an entrepreneur, you just have to get down to doing everything. Designations don't matter anymore. What really matters is you're as good as your last story or what you've delivered for your client. So you might list out as many deliverables or, the framework of scope of work that you might give. But if your brand or the client calls you up and they need something, then it has to be done, however good or bad your day is. So as an entrepreneur, my biggest lesson has been that, no work is small. And I continue to be doing everything from delivering for the clients or even if it has to be a courier of a package. So just stay humble. Stay grounded, and that's what takes you the longer distance.
And maybe if we can talk about two strong qualities to be an entrepreneur, according to you.
You need to be self-motivated. Honestly, no one's going to come back and tell you, could you deliver this? Could you close this report? Could you work on this? No, you need to be self-motivated completely. And you need to be as excited as you were on day one of your job. So you could probably come, decades of experience helps you understand the brand's journey better and plan a communication campaign better. But your excitement or your thrill, the delight that you would get looking at a new brand and planning a campaign for them, that needs to stay on. So stay self-motivated and the excitement as you would have on day one of the job.
Awesome. I think being self-motivated, I think, has been the motivation around in all these past 10 to 11 months that we have all been working from home and in this challenging time. So Pooja, tell us, something around your work from home experience and handling your team from home, as well as having a kid and a family to run. What was that overall experience about?
I'm not going to deny, I think the whole planet went through that process, and in the beginning it was fairly very difficult because you can't be in a family, have a child, and think that the child does not have an opportunity to play outside. So it did start out tough, but it gave us an opportunity to make my kid independent. Got a lot of discipline, and it helped the kid understand, I'm on a call right now, like he's speaking right now, so he's not allowed to be in the frame. This is not a social call. So these are small things that I think kids picked up. Also, this was the first time I think as a kid or any child on this planet probably got a very relaxed routine. They got an opportunity to stay back home and learn things and socialize with people within their environment. So that was good. And when it came down to work, I think a lot of clients, brands, organizations, or people that I worked with understood you're struggling between two worlds. So it was far more easier to connect and decide what time can we speak again. Does this work for everybody? Doesn't work for some of them. So these are small things which I think in a fast-paced life, all of us, kind of forget. Not to forget my running routine, 5:30, 6 a.m. in the morning every day has been the most religious routine of my life throughout this COVID. So I think when you start early, a lot of things fall in place.
And I think the people who follow you on Twitter know that you are a 6 a.m. or a 5 a.m. runner. Yes. I think we've gone through, a rampant amount of changes, but I think everything is for good. So Pooja, I would like to have a small insight on, the news consumption patterns have changed, the content consumption patterns have changed. And I think everything has been digitally amplified right now. True. So the PR industry has, of course, adapted to the changing scenarios.
Yes.
So what, according to you, have been the broad trends that have shaped up the industry? And also the brands or the clients that you were working with, what have been the changes in their outlook for the PR services being offered?
So primarily everyone's understood that all of us, whatever function we are, we can work from anywhere and yet deliver maybe better than before. Okay, and the power of own media, your own media, is really understood by people today. So a lot of brands have come to an acceptance that the peso model, that is your paid, earned, owned and shared, that the lines are completely blurring. So what really matters is how strong your content is, how well you're curating it, and how nicely how raw you're keeping it for your audience. So people have understood that, the brands or the organizations have understood that it's great to have content across various mediums and platforms, and how well we use it to create that visibility. Secondly, I've seen huge, huge, insurmountable increase and importance on internal communications. The leaders, the complete, I'm sure the leadership of each and every organization today has understood the importance of internal communications and what the teams can do when they are helping to keep your employees motivated, or even creating, those future opportunities, reducing the anxiety amongst employees. So a lot of things from internal communications has also changed. Very importantly, or necessarily, I have to say, Nafisa, I've seen brands understand the value of independent writers and focused media publications. I'm sure you guys have also seen that. Brands today are moving away that, yes, one big media house has all the power to create that messaging and information. No, they've understood independent writers can do that too. Independent media publications can do that too. So from that perspective, I think as new platforms came up to communicate internally and externally, a lot of changes have gone through our industry this year.
And also, Pooja, the viewers might want to know on this, content has taken a center stage now. you know, the business objectives of the companies or the brands have, you know, come in alliance with the PR objectives as well. So this has been a, you know, the biggest change that has occurred in the industry from the past one decade. So what are your views on the same of, you know, on the business objectives of brand being in alliance with their PR objectives?
I think it was always there. It just got highlighted or moved up a pedestal this year. As I said, you know, the leadership teams within all organizations or even brand owners, company owners have understood the importance of PR and communication. What's got even more intricate this year is that we've been able to show the organizations and companies the ROI on a communication campaign. So in the F&B industry, what I noticed is the brands that even though there was COVID and there was lockdown or, you know, services were not available, but the brands who made an effort to keep talking or keep their conversation going are not finding it difficult at all to get back when the unlock has happened. Whereas on the other side, the best restaurants who are completely shut or the brands who chose not to speak are finding it absolutely difficult right now to capture that mind space. So from a business perspective, PR professionals always understood what is it that we need to achieve as a appropriate outcome. What's changed today is that that's probably moved as the most important, you know, the first element in any communication campaign. So I think it always existed. The importance probably got noticed the same.
Yeah, and it has been amplified more so now.
Yeah.
So Pooja, you know, if I ask you, how did you convert a challenge into an opportunity? So what would that answer be from you?
Wow. I think this 2020 itself was a huge challenge. You know, in March and April, as I saw my whole industry suffer, that was a constant challenge. But a couple of months into the whole lockdown phase, I realized that, you know, I mean, all this is a natural process. It's going to take a while. What do I do? How do I make it better? I think that's when I closely, you know, started contributing even more than earlier to industry forums and platforms, especially like PRPOI. And I think that engagement with various individuals or communicators across innumerable sectors is what helped me also learn about a lot of opportunities. It helped me understand what's really happening, you know, what kind of changes different organizations are going through. And trust me, the more I spoke to people, my smaller challenges, or that's why I'm calling it smaller, my challenges seemed as small as possible, rather minuscule or non-existent at all. So I think 2020 taught us a lot of lessons, gave me a lot of opportunities, allowed me to write a lot, my favorite thing to do, because otherwise I would just land up writing what a client or a brand would need. So I could write much more this year. And talking to you, I think that itself is also an opportunity that 2020 gave me.
Of course, it is a pleasure for me as well. So Pooja, like everything is now digital, and this is also an example of a digital interaction happening right now. So what are the qualities or what are the skills that are required in the PR professionals right now to excel in this technologically enabled world that we are moving into? And also, are we as professionals or are PR professionals ready to move to the next level and be fully virtual in the years to come?
I think we're absolutely ready to just completely go virtual. I mean, if this is not virtual enough, anything beyond this, we're ready. We're already discussing how artificial intelligence can be part of the future PR campaigns, how we can incorporate data analytics or results from, you know, the data studies to bring that to our communication campaigns. I think everyone's pretty clear of, you know, life has gone beyond just phone and emails right now. I mean, we understand social media got everything down to a palm size. But now, how are you ensuring that people are consuming your message or your stories? How are you ensuring to capture that mind space? I mean, people need to go beyond the 15-second vertical videos. So there is a lot that's happening. But brands and organizations today have understood the importance of quality over quantity. So it's far more easier for me to speak to them and say that, you know, I mean, I can't promise you, you know, I mean, 10 stories is what your brand will achieve this month. It depends on what kind of, you know, what kind of story are we taking out there. So from a digital perspective, they understand that everything's moved online. PR professions are ready to harness that opportunity. We just need to understand at what level and what kind of journey the brand is, and give them that digital visibility.
Okay, so Pooja, my next question I think would really be interesting for you. You can talk on, you know, two things that you want to give a thumbs up as, you know, a trend that will continue, and two things you want to give a thumbs down for the trends that might be mundane after this year.
Wow. Thumbs up to a lot of content curation, and it has to be disruptive. Mm-hmm. Thumbs down to us worrying that, you know, will we ever go back to work? Are we going to continue working from home? Mm-hmm. Again, thumbs up to all the leadership content that can be created and distributed, but through technology, you know, I mean, purely tech-enabled. Mm-hmm. And if I have to say, thumbs down to us worry anymore, how are we managing our family, our work, our kids? I think it's all part and parcel of our life every time.
Awesome. I think everyone has gotten used to this scenario, and I think we have started enjoying it rather, right?
I agree.
So Pooja, my next question will be, like, we are in December and we are moving into 2021. So there have been many changes, innovations, and new technologies and marketing inventions popping up. So according to you, what would be the three broad innovations that, you know, might reshape the PR and comms industry in 2021 and ahead?
So I'm going to answer that with an example. One of the leading hotel brands actually took, you know, more than 90 years to build an inventory of over more than 6 lakh rooms across the globe. Whereas a brand like Airbnb got there in just 4 years. And they probably have more inventory of rooms right now. What I'm trying to say is that what they did is disruption. You know, that's the kind of stuff that's the kind of messaging, that's the kind of approach that brands need to take. I mean, they need not be so fast-paced, but there needs to be a disruption. There needs to be disruption. Either you create it through your experiential product, experiential brands, or experiential messaging. There needs to be constant disruption. And yes, the way you'd highlighted, you know, of how business goes. So I think numbers is now going to become a huge thing when it comes to any campaign, whether we discuss ROI, whether we plan what is the outcome we need, or whether we plan what kind of markets and what kind of visibility are we going for. So disruption and getting innovative with numbers.
Disruption and getting innovation with numbers. I think you have broadly summed up everything that might be the future. So Pooja, moving on to our second last part of the interaction would be, I mean, you know, recognitions like PR 40 under 40, how does platforms and recognitions like this, you know, add value to the industry or maybe your personal profile? And how do you look up to platforms like this?
I have to admit that when you get recognized by the prestigious awards of Exchange for Media, 40 under 40, it brings added responsibility and pushes me to perform more and better, you know, and constantly. There's no looking back now, because I need to justify the award or the honor that you guys have bestowed upon all the winners, actually. So it's a stepping stone to far more bigger opportunities and a definite stamp to tell the whole industry that we are capable to take on much more than what we have. I mean, this recognition means a lot, and I'm sure each and every winner will resonate with that.
Awesome. So Pooja, we'll like to end this interaction on a positive note with your message to your juniors, maybe the budding entrepreneurs and the PR professionals that are, you know, working so hard to, you know, live up to on the expectations of their clients, their managers, and everyone. Your important message to them.
Keep contributing back to the PR and the communications industry. Don't ever stop learning and upskilling, because that's how you move to the next level. You know, I mean, doesn't matter how many years of experience, never stop learning. Get out of the COVID blues. I hate to use the word, but yes, that's the new normal. So get out of it in any case. Find a safer way to, you know, do newer things. Take enough as many challenges as you can. And, work on a lot of advocacy programs, work on social cause campaigns, because it just keeps you connected to what's happening on ground. What I love right now, that's become my pet peeve is, to get smarter side gigs. Keep working on smaller campaigns, keep contributing back, and see how you learn new things from them.
Awesome. I think everyone, all your juniors might abide by your suggestions and advices. And once again, congratulations on, being on the list of E4M 40 Under 40. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
For the time.
It is a pleasure speaking to you, Nafisa. Thank you so much. And thanks to the whole team that's made this possible.
Awesome. Thank you so much.